Hey everyone, you're from Tunnel Vision TV and welcome back to the Premiere Pro tutorial series. And in this video I'm going to show you guys how to create your first edit or your first sequence inside of Premiere Pro. So basically your sequence is like your edit, and there are also a couple of ways to create a new sequence. The slow and difficult way is to right click in your project window, go to new item and then select sequence. Now if you do it this way, you need to know the sequence settings, or you need to know what frame rate and things like that you're going to work on. So let's say for instance you know that you shot it on a DSLR. I'm going to go to digital SLR here, and then I'm going to go to HD 1080p, and let's say you shot this on 30 frames a second. I'm going to click on that one, click on OK, and it's going to create a new sequence with those settings that you just selected. So this is the kind of difficult way or the slow way of doing it. I'm going to delete the sequence and I'm going to show you guys a very easy and quick way to do this. So I'm just going to highlight the sequence one and delete it. All right, just by pressing delete on the keyboard. So easy way, I'm going to take my first clip. So these are all shot at 30 frames a second. I'm going to take this clip and I'm going to drag it into this empty space here at the bottom. Release, and it's going to automatically create a new sequence using the settings from that clip 01. So because this clip was shot at 30 frames a second, it's going to create a sequence with a frame rate of 30 frames a second. And you can see it's got a little bit of a different icon next to it. That's how I know that's a sequence. And it's going to take the name of that clip that you dragged into it. So now I can go ahead and you can rename this one. So I'm going to click and I'm going to call this edit space 01. Alright, also you don't want to keep your sequences inside of your video folder, so I'm going to drag it out. And then I'm going to create a new bin or a new folder, so right click, new bin, and I'm going to call this edits. So this is where I will keep all my edits, and then I'm going to take this sequence or this edit, drag it into the edits folder. Right, there you go, there's your first sequence. So now if we go into the sequence here at the bottom, you can see it's got that clip that you dragged into it automatically at the beginning of that sequence. And you don't really have to start with that one. You can now go ahead and you can highlight this clip here in the sequence, and you can just delete it by pressing delete on your keyboard. So it will keep the settings, and now you can basically start adding clips to the sequence just by dragging them in here, and yeah, everything will be working fine. So if you want to playback, you can just drag this slider or this playhead around to view your sequence. And if you want to playback, just press space on the keyboard, it's going to play it back. And you can just press space again to stop it. So we're going to go through all that in a later video. For this video, I just want to focus on how to create a new sequence. So I'm going to delete these clips again. And what you can also do is you can now go ahead and you can duplicate this edit. So let's say you want to have multiple edits, or you're working on different versions of your edit. You want to have different sequence versions. So let's say I'm going to add clip one to the sequence and maybe clip two to the back of it. So and now we want to duplicate the sequence. Very simply, I'm going to right click on edit one here under my edits, and I'm going to click on duplicate. It's going to create a copy, and now I can also rename this one. So I'm going to click on it and I'm going to call this one edit two, like that. And now if I double click on this edit two to open it, it's going to open up a new tab here at the bottom. As you can see, we've got edit one, edit two. So now on edit two, I can delete these clips or I can modify it. Let's bring in another clip and maybe another clip like that, and maybe a third one, something like that. Okay, so now we're working on edit two, and I can easily switch back to edit one just by clicking on this edit one tab. And now I can work on edit one. And if I want to go back to edit 2, I can just click on edit 2 right here. So really easy. You can also click on this little X to close this tab. It's not going to delete that edit. It's going to stay here under your bins. And then you're just working on your edit 1 again. So let's say we want to work on edit 2 again. I'm going to double click on edit 2. It's going to bring in that tab again. And then I can go ahead and I can close edit 1 again. So now it's only showing edit 2 in this tab view. So it's always a good idea to create a bin called either edits or sequences and try and keep all your edits underneath that. Another reason why you will duplicate it is just for versioning. So let's say you're working on edit one and you're doing some changes, and now you want to kind of save that as an edit one and you want to create a new sequence from that, then you'll duplicate it, call the new one edit two, and then you start working on edit two. And then let's say at a later stage you want to create a new edit from that, duplicate edit 2, rename that edit 3, and then you carry on working with that. Just so that you can go back to, let's say you want to go back to edit 2 at a later stage, then you've got that option. So that's how easy it is to create sequences or edits inside of Premiere Pro. I'll see you guys in the next video.